The Tukituki electorate is still very much in recovery mode following the destruction of Cyclone Gabrielle. Over the last 30 years, Tukituki has swung between National and Labor. After a long lean to the centre-right, Labor won the seat in 2020. ACT and the Greens are pushing for the party vote in the seat, and the contest is shaping up between two candidates with a whole lot of history.
Party vote, National!
Morning rush hour, Havelock North, and that's candidate Catherine Wedd, letting commuters know she intends taking Tukituki back for National. Over in Hastings, Labor's Anna Lorck, the incumbent Tukituki MP, is starting the day with these constituents who call themselves Polyactive, a Flaxmere community group focused on well-being. Anna Lorck is a former journalist, businesswoman, district health board member and mum of five. This will be her fourth time contesting the Tukituki seat, which she won off National in 2020 with a margin of 1,050 votes. Along with Hastings and Havelock North, the electorate stretches out to Waimarama and Cape Kidnappers and down to just north of Waipawa.
Is this your campaign office?
Oh, it is too. Yes, you've kind of got to have everything in a provincial electorate. We've got the gumboots, we've got the different pairs of shoes, we've got the wardrobe in here, high heel, that's just if you want to look a little bit nicer, kind of walking around different kind of areas. And then we've got the sneakers, which basically you pound the pavement with at the moment on the campaign trail on the doors.
Okay, so you're good to go.
Yeah, so I'm good to go. Yeah, definitely. Good to go to the back house.
But before we do, here's where Catherine Wedd, age 17, began her political quest, Youth Parliament.
Why should the taxpayers have to support these politicians that we simply do not need?
After a law degree, journalism.
Catherine Loft is with us again from Norsewood. Catherine.
Yes, well, it's been all go here at the Command Centre this morning.
I just thought I'd bring you along here today to one of our family-owned businesses.
Now we're 2023 in one of the very few pack houses around Hastings operating after the devastating February cyclone.
Growers have found it really, really tough for the past 6 years under this government. There's been so much compliance, regulation, cost, and then we've been compounded by a cyclone where we've seen 50% impact to the
orchards. But the government are offering them a loan, is that right?
Yeah, so it was very, very slow from the outset, so there were no decisions very quickly and the funding didn't come quickly.
The National candidate's last job was in the apple industry.
So you've done a lot of things, Catherine. You've been a TV reporter, so of course that sets you up for the top job.
Oh, absolutely. Top job, absolutely. I've worked
in the horticultural industry.
Definitely. No, and I feel that I do have a lot to offer because I have got a legal background, media background, marketing background, and I now want to take all of that practical commercial experience and advocate for our community here and the people of Tukituki.
Not so long ago, the Labor and National candidates for Tukituki worked together in Havelock North.
You were business partners, right, in a PR company?
Yeah, I built the business.
You worked for Anna Lorck, is that right?
I worked in marketing with Anna, yes.
I haven't seen her much since then.
Is that difficult, though, now that you're sort of opponents?
No, not at all. I think we're both just obviously going for the same job, and that happens all the time throughout New Zealand.
The best focus I can do is focus on the job I'm working on now, and that's what I do every day.
Not your opponent?
Absolutely not.
Anna Lorck's parliamentary career began with plenty of fizz.
What did I say? Barock is in the morning.
But it's in her electorate where she has a reputation as a high-energy MP.
You say go!
I'm a workhorse politician, so that means I have to get out and I work with people on the ground.
Do you think you can still hold on to it, even though some people would describe this electorate or your victory in 2020 as part of the red wave Jacinda effect?
The way I hold on to this electorate is from the work I've been doing, and I only deserve to be here if people do see me as a hard-working local MP.
The constant rumble of trucks along Hastings' back roads is in fact music to the ears of local residents overwhelmed with silt from Cyclone Gabrielle.
Well done, keep up the hard work.
The trucks are hauling the unwanted silt from around the region and dumping it on a family orchard to become a stop bank. The orchardist came up with the win-win idea, but his daughter says the local MP made it happen.
So he came up with that idea, yeah. And then what happened? How did he get it out there?
Anna.
Yeah.
We tried. We got no traction. And then I contacted Anna, and she came down, and she could see it. And she went from there for us. Man, it's flying fast. Our place was just absolutely annihilated.
6 months on, the frames are up on the houses that accommodate the RSE workers to replace the homes destroyed by the cyclone.
They had to swim to our property across the road.
They swam out of here?
Yes.
Across the road?
Yes.
Every day we're making progress, and I think all of us would like it to happen faster. But
it's been difficult with three different ministers looking after the recovery.
And my job has been on the ground. My job hasn't been difficult. The challenges in my job have been actually helping people and making sure I'm there for them as much as I can.
Just out doing a little bit of campaigning today.
Right.
How's it all going for you?
Oh, not bad.
Good.
No, good.
Yeah.
We need a change of government,
yes,
though, to get this economy stimulated.
Yes.
Over in Havelock North, Catherine Wedd is meeting with small business owners and talking tough on crime.
Gangs is a really, really big one here in Tukituki. We've seen a 71% increase in gang membership alone here in Hawke's Bay.
So what can you do
about the gang issue here? So our party's going to introduce policy that will crack down on the gangs.
We've got Wyn Drabble here. Wyn's a teacher.
Hello.
Hi, Wyn, good to see you again.
I'm back at work.
A few streets away, Anna Lorck is introducing us to a popular local teacher, happily singing the MP's praises for helping him navigate surgery waiting lists.
And you came to the initial assessment with me.
Yes, because I think we talked about, that's the most important thing for me about being a local MP,
yeah,
is that when I'm asked for help, that I keep on the journey with you. You did ask. Who's that? You're not Rob?
I'm Rob, yes.
Oh,
Rob Douglas, hi.
Hi.
And Rob's not on any of the hoardings he's putting up because
we're campaigning for the party vote in this area.
Rob Douglas's uncle, there's the clue, co-founded the At Party 30 years ago.
So Rob, are you tired of people asking you about your uncle?
Oh look, I'm very proud of Roger. Roger Douglas, he did an awful lot of good for New Zealand.
Didn't he say a few weeks ago he wouldn't vote for ACT?
Well, I think what he said was that he was a swing voter, but I'm pretty confident that he will vote for ACT.
ACT candidate Rob Douglas may be pushing the party vote, but at 16 on the list, there's a chance he may be joining in Parliament whoever the people of Tukituki choose to represent them.
Who's going to be there for them? Anna Lorck is your local MP for Tukituki.
I really want to stand up for the people of Tukituki and be their local MP.
Wedd for Tukituki! Two ticks blue! Woo!